Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to explain you the introduction to heap tree. What is heap tree? Basically, heap tree is used while the sorting is done with the help of heap data structure. If you want to sort the elements using heap data structure, in that case you will require the heap tree. Heap tree is nothing but a binary tree. Basically or mainly, it is a complete binary tree where all the elements are stored in a special order. So do you know the construction of complete binary tree? Do you know the meaning? Do you know the concept of complete binary tree? If not, you can go through my previous video where I had already explained the types of binary tree, in which I have covered the complete binary tree. For this, I am providing a shortcut link in this right up corner. So binary heap tree is a complete binary tree, and the construction of complete binary tree is nothing but the special order of the elements which are stored in an array. So mainly, when you want to construct a heap tree, there are two different properties of the heap tree. A first property is, if value in a parent node is greater than the value in its two children node, then tree is called as max heap. So what is max heap tree? The max heap tree where every parent node is having the value greater than that of its children. If a single child is there, then also the parent node value should be greater, and if more than one parent, that is two children, because this is a binary tree, we need to keep in mind maximum two children will be there, so its value again must be greater than the children node. Parent value, the value of the parent node is greater than the children node. So if the parent is greater, then this heap is called as max heap. And the other way around, if parent node is smaller than that the value present in its children node, then that heap tree is called as min heap tree. So there are two ways in which I can construct the heap tree. The first one is max heap, the another one is min heap. We need to keep in mind, in max heap the parent node is greater than that of the children node, and in min heap the parent node is smaller than that of the children nodes. Now we'll see some of the example where I am going to explain you the max heap tree as well as min heap tree. Here you can see that there are 1, 2, and 3 parent nodes. If we'll consider 12 as a parent node, its children, that is 10 and 9, are having less value than that of the parent node. Means parent is greater than that of the children node. If we'll consider 10, 10 is a parent node which is greater than its children node, that is 5 and 6. In the same way, 9 is a parent node who is having the greater value than that of its child node 1. In the other way around, in the opposite, min heap is a tree where parent node is having the less value than that of its children, that is 1 is less value than that of its children, that is 5 and 9. If 5 is a parent node, then its children are 10 and 6, which are having greater value than that of its parent node. And if 9 is a parent node, then the 9 is having less value than that of its children, that is 12. So in this way we can identify what is min heap tree, which one is the min heap tree and which one is the max heap tree. You need to keep in mind that every parent node should satisfy a property. If it is a max heap, parent node should be greater than its children. If it is a min heap, parent node should be less than of its children. If these properties are followed by the tree, then and then only we can say that the tree is max heap tree, as well as, or the tree is mean heap tree. Now we'll see which data structure are used for the construction of heap tree. So when I want to construct a heap tree, mainly I need to take care of, I need to have the knowledge of array data structure as well as tree data structures. So for the array data structures, I am providing you a shortcut link over here, how to implement array in C, what is array in C programming. And for a tree data structure, I have already explained it to you in the video in which I have covered the binary tree with its different types. So basically these two data structures are used for the construction of heap tree. Array is the most feasible way to represent the heap tree, and with the help of array we can construct the complete binary tree in very easy way. So binary heap is a complete binary tree, so it can be easily represented as array. All these things are already covered in the construction of complete binary tree in the video types of binary tree. The benefits of array and tree is array based representation is very much space efficient, very less space requires if you are going to use an array for the construction of heap tree or a complete binary tree. Which are the steps we need to follow for the construction of heap tree? So there are two steps we need to follow. The first one is construction of a complete binary tree from the given array elements. This is your first step. Now to construct a complete binary tree, there are again internal few steps which are already explained in my previous video. And the next step is to heapify the tree to form it as a heap tree. So heapify is a new term in this video. So what do you mean by heapify? What we need to do to construct a heap tree is nothing but the heapify. To know about heapify, please stay tuned to my channel Tech Talks. Thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like the video. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks and share it with your friends. Keep the bell ringing, as the ringing bell gives you the notification of new videos. Thank you. Here I am providing you some of the shortcut links for more videos. Please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks to gain knowledge about more data structures. Thank you.